Hello students, today we are going to revise the second topic from the pharmaceutics 2 subject, that is the posology. It is a very small topic from your subject, but it is very important one. One question will be compulsory in your examination. So let us start the revision of the posology. Within 10 minutes you will be able to revise it. So the term posology, it consists of two Greek words, posos means how much and logos means science. So how much quantity of drug has to be taken and the calculation of that or that science is called as an posology. So the definition of posology, in short, it is the study of dose or quantity of drug. It is the science or study of dose calculation or quantity of drug. So that is called as an posology. Remember, posos means how much and logos means science. Next, what are the factors that are affecting the calculation of a dose or quantity of a drug? A full question may be asked in the examination. That is, what are the factors, explain in brief, or as individual factor may be asked for the short note, like synergism, antagonism, or additive effect, or idiosyncrasy, or tachyphylaxis. So these are the factors which are affecting the calculation of a dose or quantity. First one, age, sex, body weight, route of administration, time of administration, environmental factors, accumulation, synergism, additive effect, antagonism, idiosyncrasy, and tachyphylaxis. So these are the factors which are affecting the calculation of a dose. Or when you are calculating the dose or quantity of drug, you have to remember these factors. So let us see one by one in very brief. First one, age. So the dose for the children or the old people is less because the excretion rate is less in case of children and the old people as compared to the adult, because in adults high dose is required than the children and the old people because the rate of excretion is more. Second one is the sex. Females adult required less dose as compared to the male adult. Third one is the body weight. Of course, heavy weight person require the large dose than the normal weight person. So when there is a more body weight, more dose will be the required. Then the route of administration. When you are giving the drug by the IV route, the less quantity or small dose will be required. When you are giving the drug by the oral or other route, high dose than the IV route will be required. Then accumulation. When the drug is excreted slowly, because of slow rate of excretion, the drug will get accumulate into the body and it may produce the toxic effect. So the concentration of drug is increased in the body and that is called as an accumulation. So in such cases you need to give the drug in less quantity. Then synergism. Suppose three drugs are given, A, B and C. So when they are given individually or when they are given in combination, they increases the rate or intensity of the action, and that is called as a synergism. Next one is the additive effect. When the drug is given individually A, B, the total pharmacological action will be the sum of the pharmacological action, that is A plus B plus C, and that is called as an additive effect. In such cases you need to reduce the dose of the drug. Next one is the antagonism. The drugs which are in contradictory in pharmacological action, for example A and B, which neutralizes each other action, that is the antagonism. So in such cases you need to concentrate on the calculation of the dose of the drug. Next one is the idiosyncrasy. When extraordinary pharmacological response is produced than the desired pharmacological action, it is called as an idiosyncrasy. In other words, it may be also called as a drug allergy. Idiosyncrasy means what?
when extraordinary response of a drug than the desired pharmacological action is produced is called as an idiosyncrasy. Then tachyphylaxis, when you are administering the drug in repeated doses, what happens? It may block the cell receptor. It may block the cell receptor and it decreases the pharmacological action. And if you also increase the dose of the drug, the pharmacological action will not get increased. That is called as an tachyphylaxis. Remember, what is tachyphylaxis? When you are administering the drug in repeated doses, it may block the cell receptor and it may decrease its pharmacological action. Although we increase the dose of the drug, the pharmacological action will not get increased, and that is called as an tachyphylaxis. So these are the 10 factors which are affecting the route of a drug, dose of a drug. Then how will you calculate the dose of a drug? There are various formulas which are given in your books. Out of that, first one is the Young's formula for the calculation of a dose of a child. When the age of the child is between 4 to 20 years, you are using this Young's formula. The dose of a child is equal to age in years divided by age in years plus 12 whole into the adult dose. Note, you have to take the dose in milligram. So what is the Young's formula? Age in years divided by age in years plus 12 into adult dose. Dehling's formula, when the age of the infant is up to 2 years, the dose is equal to age in years divided by 70 into the adult dose. What is Dehling's formula? It is used for the infants up to the 2 years, age in years divided by 70 into the adult dose. Next one is the Freud's formula. When the age is given in month and the child age is up to 2 years, the dose is calculated by the Freud's formula, which is equal to age in months divided by 150 into adult dose. When the age is given in month, you have to calculate the dose by the formula, Freud's formula or Freud's rule, age in months divided by 150 into adult dose. Then Clark's formula, dose of a child is equal to weight in kilogram divided by 70 into adult dose. When the dose is given in kilogram, weight is given in kilogram, dose is calculated by the formula, weight in kilogram divided by 70 into the adult dose. So these are the various formulas you have to remember. We will quickly revise. Young's formula is equal to age in years divided by age in year plus 12 into adult dose. Dehling's formula is equal to age in years divided by 70 into adult dose. Freud's rule is equal to age in months divided by 150 into adult dose. And Clark's formula is equal to weight in kg divided by 70 into adult dose. Thank you. So this is about the posology. You revise it and remember the formulas. Thank you.